Hey, what's up guys? Racer53 here from the RC Tech Forums. Today I'm going to be doing a video for JMKE on the RC Tech Forums. That's his name on YouTube as well. If I can get the annotations to work on YouTube, I'll put a link to his channel in the video. Click that, check his channel out. He's got some pretty cool videos of him running his cars. But he wanted to know how to properly set the gear mesh, as well as the sound of a properly set gear mesh versus one that's too tight and shoved up against the spur gear. So, we're going to go over the sounds as well as how I like to set the gear mesh. There's a couple different methods. I'll go over the one I use. So I'm going to bring you guys in on a zoom in and we'll get started today. Alright guys, so you can see I changed camera angles here. I'm going to go over a couple things before I actually throw the pinion gear on. So whenever you do this, let me make sure my hand's in the camera angle. On the set screw here, you want to apply a little bit of Loctite because sometimes the motor vibrations can loosen this screw. You probably want to apply Loctite to these two motor screws too. I've actually had stuff happen before where the motor vibrates at a certain frequency and it'll loosen the screws and it'll go back and strip out the spur gear and go forward. So make sure you apply Loctite. Just use the blue stuff. When you apply it to the pinion gear, make sure none of the blue gets into the teeth. You want to brush that out with a toothbrush or something. Let's see. Okay, yeah, I think we'll go ahead and throw it on. Now there's a couple different methods for actually setting the mesh. Let me loosen up the motor and slide this back real quick. Some people like to use a piece of paper, some people like to do it by sound, all sorts of different ways. Now in this case I'm going to, there's usually two sides, one with the screw and then one with the teeth. I'm going to put the one with the screw on the right. Some cars you have to put it the other way around, it really doesn't matter. Now something you want to make sure here, you want to make sure you get, you don't have to, but the teeth flush. Let me tighten this down, I'll show you. So it's flush here, so if you're looking at it from the side, there's no shadow. It just makes it easier when you're setting the mesh. So make sure this is tightened down. Again, you want to use Loctite. I didn't in this case just because it's a mess and I don't want to deal with it right now. Then you're going to slide this forward some. And what you're looking for, and I'm going to zoom in on this in a minute so you guys can see it better, but you're looking to get this as snug as you can up here and still be able to rock this gear just a little bit. So you're probably going to have to tighten these down enough to where you can just barely slide the motor. Let me get it. And then you're just going to slowly move it up until where you can barely rock that. You don't want it too far. You don't want to shove it all the way up because that causes friction that you don't need. You're not wanting to do that. That's going to overheat your motor. So bring it back just a little bit, just to where you can barely rock those teeth. Again, some people like to put a piece of paper in there and then shove it all the way up. Some people like to use other methods. This is just the way I use. It's how I did it. It's pretty easy. You're basically looking for you just be able to barely rock that and it rocks between the teeth. So I'm going to get a zoom in on this and then we'll come back and we'll look at the sounds it makes. So yeah, I'm going to go into zoom in real quick. Alright guys, so as you can see we've got a zoom in here on the pinion gear and the spur gear. And you can see that I've got what I'm looking for. I've got just a little bit of play when I rock that spur gear back and forth between the pinion teeth. So hopefully this picks up on camera okay. It looks like it is. Now, occasionally, like I said, these spur gears, sometimes they'll be a little bit uneven on one side. Sometimes they'll have a little bit of a tighter fit as you rotate it, and then it'll go to a looser section. You generally want to set it at the tighter section. So if I rotated the spur gear, it would rock a little bit more in some sections because it's a little bigger. Most of the spur gears are pretty even. Some of them have little fluctuations like that. This is an associated one. Kimbrough is supposed to be good. I'll have to try one of theirs sometime. But that was just for you guys to know. So generally you want to set it on the tightest part, which this is. And you want to be able to rock it back and forth a little bit. So that's what I'm looking for. It's not too tight. It's not too loose. So that's what you're looking for when you set your gear mesh. Alright guys, I'm back here. I switched the camera angle up. One other thing I wanted to show you guys was the sound a properly set mesh sounds like, and then one where it's too tight and it's shoved all the way up against the spur gear. So, I'm going to shove this motor and pinion gear up all the way against the spur gear, and then I'll move it back and set it for a proper mesh. So you guys can hear there's a little bit different of sound. So, again, you don't want to do this when you're trying to get the proper mesh. I'm just showing you guys because it'll sound different. And, yeah, I want to show you guys what that sounded like. So, let me throw this tire back on here. And that way you guys can hear. Hopefully I'm staying in camera angle. Not used to working with the camera, sorry guys. Throw this tire back on here, plug in my battery in, we'll be good to go. got it. Sorry for the wait, guys. All right, so again, this is too tight of a mesh. You guys can hear it's struggling to spin. It's too tight. That's going to put a lot of strain on the motor. You'll overheat your motor. Yeah, you don't want to do that. So now I'm going to set the mesh properly and then let you guys hear what that sounds like, and it'll be a lot smoother. There won't be as much stress on the motor, and overall a lot better. You also want to make sure you don't have the mesh too loose. Excuse me. Too loose where it's back all the way, because that'll just strip your spur gear out. So let me set this properly. I'm trying to work with the camera here. I don't want my head in the picture. That should do it. Again, if you guys have seen my other videos, this is my T4. It's one of the cars I do these videos on. Alright, so that should do it. Yeah, that's a lot better. So let me throw this tire back on and I'll show you guys what a proper gear mesh sounds like. Almost got it. Alright. Throw this back on, radio on. Alright, so this is the proper gear mesh. So it's a lot smoother. There's not that screeching noise. Another thing you can notice, if the gear mesh is too tight, the wheels will almost like immediately stop after you let go of the throttle. If it's looser, they'll spin for a little bit. It'll coast. So that's another good thing with having a properly set gear mesh. So let's see, something else I wanted to go over. I guess that was it. Again, this is just the method I use. Some other guys, like I said, use the paper method, something else. This is just the one that works best for me. So, if you guys like this video, subscribe to my channel, like the video, leave a comment. If you got any questions about anything RC related, PM me on Racer53 on RC Tech or YouTube, obviously. So, let me know if this helped you guys out. Racer53 out.